knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
Back when we learned calculus, we learned about multivariable functions and their partial derivatives, as well as the concept of the contour lines of such a function. It turns out that these tools can help us solve another class of differential equations. Suppose that we have a scalar-valued function of two variables. Call it f of x, y. If we plot the function z equals f of x, y in 3D Cartesian space, we will get a surface where the elevation above the x, y plane is given by the value of the function f at each point in the plane. If we take a horizontal slice across this surface at some height, represented by this plane, then the plane will intersect the surface at some set of points that form a curve, called a contour line. Starting at any point on this contour line, if we take steps around the surface but still stay on the line, the value of the function f of x, y remains constant. Suppose that we take some tiny step along a vector h that takes us from the point x, y, f of x, y to the point x plus dx, y plus dy, f of x, y. Given this condition, we must have chosen the components dx and dy to be such that we remain on the contour line in order for the value of f to be the same at both points. If we were to take the directional derivative of f in the direction of our small step h, we should find it to be zero, since there is no change in f. Recall that the gradient operator, represented by this triangle symbol, nabla, gives us a vector field showing the direction in which we should make a small step to cause the greatest possible change in f. We can find the component of this change in any given step direction by taking the dot product with our step vector. Since we require zero change in f, we get the equation nabla f dotted with the vector h, which is a step along the contour line, equals zero. We can evaluate the gradient as a vector of partial derivatives, take the dot product, and we end up with the total derivative of f, given by del f del x dx plus del f del y dy equals zero. From here, if we name the partial derivatives as functions m of x, y, and n of x, y, we can get something that looks a lot like a differential equation, m of x, y, dx plus n of x, y, dy equals zero. But what's the point of all this? If we are faced with a differential equation that looks like this general form, m of x, y, dx plus n of x, y, dy equals zero, we can try to reverse engineer it to find out what multivariable function f it could have come from, and then any contour line of this function will be a solution to our differential equation. The first step is to check if there even exists such a function, which is actually simple. If we assume that f does exist, we can express its second partial derivatives in terms of the first partial derivatives of the functions in our differential equation m and n, which we defined as the partial derivatives of f like this. We can now use the fact that when we take a mixed partial derivative, it doesn't matter which order we take the derivatives in, which is a result known as Clairaut's theorem. We get that the partial derivative of m with respect to y must be equal to the partial derivative of n with respect to x. This is the condition for exactness that we can check when faced with any dE of the general form m of x, y, dx plus n of x, y, dy equals zero. And if this condition is true, then we can proceed to solve it as an exact differential equation. We refer to f as the potential function for the differential equation. Okay, that's enough abstract math. Let's see an example for the rest. Suppose we are faced with the differential equation dy dx equals x squared minus 4y squared all over 8xy plus y to the fourth. We need to get it into our general form of an exact equation. We can clear the denominators and move everything to one side to get this. We can now identify our functions m and n. M of xy will be 4y squared minus x squared, and n of xy will be 8xy plus y to the fourth. Now we check for exactness. The partial derivative of m with respect to y is 8y, and the partial derivative of n with respect to x is 8y. Since the partials are equal, we have an exact differential equation. So where can we go from here? Well, we know there must exist some potential function f of xy such that its partial derivative with respect to x is our function m, and its partial derivative with respect to y is our function n. And we know both of them, so we can integrate both of these equations with respect to just the one variable to obtain two expressions that must be equal to each other. For the first equation, when integrating with respect to x, 4y squared only depends on y, so it's just a constant, so it becomes 4y squared x. And then we have minus x cubed over 3. And don't forget the constant plus c, but this time the constant could actually be any function of the variable y, since its partial derivative with respect to x would be 0. So we will write plus little f of y instead. Now for the second equation, integrating with respect to y this time, 8xy becomes 8x times y squared over 2, which is 4xy squared. And then y to the fourth becomes y to the fifth over 5, and then plus an arbitrary constant, now written as plus g of x for the same reason. These two expressions must somehow be equal to each other because they both define the function f of xy. Certainly, the 4xy squared terms match, but what about the others? Notice that if we choose the functions little f of y and g of x to each be equal to whatever doesn't match on the other side of the equation, we will have both sides equal to each other. In this case, that means letting f of y equal y to the fifth over 5, and g of x equal minus x cubed over 3. And we can now see that the two sides are indeed the same. We have found our function f of xy. It will be equal to 4xy squared minus x cubed over 3 plus y to the fifth over 5. What this means is that the equations of all the contour lines of this multivariable function f of xy will satisfy our differential equation. So we can just set f of xy equal to any arbitrary constant c, and we will have our implicit general solution to this exact differential equation. 4xy squared minus x cubed over 3 plus y to the fifth over 5 equals a constant c. In this case, rearranging for y to get an explicit solution seems tricky, so we'll leave it like this. As always, if we had boundary conditions, we'd put them in now to find the constant c. Let's practice by checking comprehension. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.